National Heavyweight Champion Ted DiBiase moving out against Randy Barber. One fall, 10-minute time limit. DiBiase in the black trunks. A taller, possibly more powerful man than Barber, but Barber has good quickness. High waistlift takedown, and brother, DiBiase very quickly riding into his man and into the ropes, and DiBiase could well be defined as a very angry young man. Nice to have Tony and Roger Rixom from Manchester, England, visiting here today at the WTBS Sports Arena. And nice to see Pat Minahan back with us and fully recovered as well. DiBiase really wrestles with a vengeance, Ole.
He sure does, and we were talking about people being upset. DiBiase is really upset. I just heard now that he was complaining that Tommy Rich is going to be on television. Well, like it or not, I don't know that we have to worry about what Ted DiBiase thinks. He may be the champion. He's telling everybody how great he is now. But Tommy Rich is going to be here on TV. Tommy Rich is going to be allowed to fulfill those contracts that he had prior to. And we're going to still wait and find out what the final word is going to be.
Precisely. DiBiase, of course, not a picture of model humility, that's for sure. Back to his feet with a side headlock on Barber. Now Barber fires him off, and it is DiBiase catching him with a good shoulder smash. Drives him back to the mat. DiBiase brings him up a full body slam. For those 26 vertebrae, getting a pretty good jarring now from DiBiase. Hip lock takedown. Referee Scrappy McGowan checking that side headlock. DiBiase, of course, a second-generation competitor. The son of the late Iron Mike DiBiase, who was one of the all-time greats.
He was a good wrestler, a very great wrestler, I would say. And, you know, that brings to mind that there was not long ago that Ted DiBiase was before the committee, the National Wrestling Alliance, and was at that time considered to be one of the top contenders for the world heavyweight title, now held by Ric Flair. And when he adopted the attitude that he was just better than anybody, he said, well, if I can't get a match, I think at that time we were talking about race, then I'll just, I'll take the national title. Came back from Japan, as we know, and he did just exactly that.
He did indeed. He has been remarkably accurate in his predictions so far. I'll tell you one thing. He doesn't want to push the NWA president, Bob Geiger, too far, however. There is a very, very firm but fair-minded president of the NWA. But he is going to make a lot of money as a national heavyweight champion if he holds on to the belt.
Well, he sure is.
DiBiase now rear chin lock on Barber, keeping the pressure on. Referee Scrappy McGowan checking that throat to make sure that there was a clearance there. Now DiBiase drives a knee into the upper chest, and Barber is having his problems. That air supply has been cut short. DiBiase still doing a lot of percussion to the chest and throat area.
Well, you know one thing about DiBiase, since he was reprimanded before and in fact suspended and fined, he's done some things that we don't approve of, but everything, once again, is done within the legal system. He's been very careful. He hasn't overstepped the bounds, but he, at the same time, has just become, I think, that much more intense and probably more brutal.
No question about that, and it's DiBiase who continues to have things well under control. Barber coming up very slowly. DiBiase off the ropes catches him once again. Again, DiBiase brings him over in a beautiful power slam. Well executed power slam. Let's see if we can possibly catch that in slow motion. An instant replay of that, and you'll see the effectiveness of this man, the national heavyweight champion, Ted DiBiase. Notice here now, the Irish whip, as Barber comes off the ropes, DiBiase brings him over into a perfectly executed power slam, puts him down, has that far leg hooked, he bulldogs it, and gets the three count.
You know one thing, Gordon Soley, you know I'm real good at that power slam too, and Ted DiBiase in Marietta, Georgia, January the 7th, it's going to be me and you, heads up, and then we're going on tour, we're talking about Altoona, Pennsylvania, we're talking about Charleston, West Virginia, Troy, Ohio, and it goes on, because now we are the tag team champions. Tell them about it.
You know it, and I want to thank all the people out there who gave us all the support. You know, it means a lot to me and my brother to hold these belts. We just want to thank everybody in Michigan, West Virginia, Atlanta, Portland, Oregon.
And Marietta has a real big surprise.
We got a big surprise.
Brett, my brother, Bob Armstrong, Marietta, January the 7th. Ted DiBiase, watch out. We're coming on tour to saw you, brothers. It's the year for us,
Gordon. Watch out, Roy.
We're coming on.
Fight against Tommy Wildfire Rich. As you know, of course, a lot of controversy surrounding Tommy Rich right now because he and Ted DiBiase did sign contracts. And Rich being allowed to complete his contract, but he is fighting the situation where he wants to continue wrestling, obviously. Bond trapped by Rich now. Rich with an inverted press on him. Now Rich goes to an arm bar. Bond makes it to the ring ropes, and that forces the break. Good spin under takedown by Tommy Rich.
Well, right now, certainly Tommy's wondering, and I know you're wondering, I'm wondering, we're all waiting word, and we supposedly are going to be finding out sometime yet, hopefully before the hour is over. I was just back there by the control room, and I see DiBiase staggering around. He's as mad as a hornet. But once again, this match is going to take place, whether Mr. DiBiase likes it or not.
All right, and it is Tommy Wildfire.
What's going on here? What's this man doing in the ring? He signed a contract that if he lost Christmas night, he was going to leave. He wasn't going to wrestle anymore. What, is he not a man of his word? What are you doing here, man?
Well, we've got a problem here. We've got a problem here in DiBiase protesting the situation. And all right, DiBiase creating quite a furor here at the ringside. Ole Anderson trying to calm him down. Freddie Miller and Roger Bond makes it back in.
I guarantee you something will be done about this.
Mr. DiBiase either goes back or we can make certain that there'll be some arrangements made where he can be suspended again.
And I think that's the word that finally told on Mr. DiBiase. I think he finally realized what sort of jeopardy he was putting himself into. Meanwhile, Tommy Wildfire Rich moving extremely well against Roger Bond. Bond, a fine competitor. But at the moment, having more than a share of problems with Tommy Rich. And, of course, the thing is, of course, that Tommy may well be making, at this point in time, could well be making his final appearance here on World Championship Wrestling. As you heard Ole Anderson say, we are awaiting the decision at this time because, indeed, he did sign a contract stating that if he lost, he would cease wrestling. So it's an interesting posture that he's been put into at this point. All right, Rich now, an Irish whip off the ropes, caught in right to the midsection.
All DiBiase could tell me back there is that he's the best thing that's ever happened to wrestling. Well, it's a shame to have to see a talent like that go down the drain like that. But the fact that he's good, I guess we don't argue about it. The fact that he's a champion, we can't say anything about that. But he's just not going to go run everybody and tell them what the heck to do. That just isn't going to happen.
Yeah, the only problem we have here is that Tommy is of legal age, and he did sign a contract, and that very frankly has me concerned.
Well, me too, and I'm certain that nobody's more concerned than Tommy. As he indicated, he said he wanted to fight it because there were some circumstances which would indicate that maybe there's room for fighting. Maybe there's a way that we could take it to the NWA, or we could take it even through the court system. Certainly, DiBiase winning left a lot of question as to how it was done. And Tommy's got an awful lot of encouragement. And I know when I was on tour, a lot of people were talking to me and said, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? I don't know. But they did indicate that they would like to see Tommy fight it. And we know that we call Tommy Rich Wildfire. He didn't get that name by just sitting on his backside. I think if anybody's going to fight, certainly it would be Tommy Rich.
And Ole brought up an excellent point, too. Not only is it his own fighting heart, but also at the request of thousands of fans who are solidly behind Tommy Wildfire Rich and want to see him continue in his chosen professional sport, that, of course, of wrestling. And Rich explodes with the right hand that time. Now a good Irish whip. And Rich catches him once again, and Bond goes back to the canvas. Rich drives the knee into the pectoralis majors, and Mr. Bond has got himself a lot of problems here as Rich again closes in. Another Irish whip. High backdrop. And Bond has got himself a lot of problems. Rich again punishing him. I'll tell you what, if in fact it does become his last appearance here on World Championship Wrestling, he is indeed acquitting himself extremely well.
He sure is. I'll tell you, he's under an awful lot of pressure, and it takes an awful lot for a man to be able to go out there and wrestle with the things that he's got on his mind. I can't imagine anybody else in that particular situation even wanting to come to television, much less going to fulfill their contracts like Tommy did, and he acquitted himself very, very well. He had some outstanding matches, and did a tremendous job of wrestling.
High vertical body block by Tommy Wildfire Rich, and that scores the pinfall. Let me see if I can't get Tommy over here for just a moment.
Tommy?
Let me ask him some questions, if I may. Find out just exactly. Tommy, I guess you realize full well more than any of us that this may be your final appearance on World Championship Wrestling.
Yes, sir, Gruna. Well aware of it. Just one of them things. Just got to wait and see what happens, I guess.
Well, of course, there are some questions surrounding the manner in which you lost that particular match to Ted DiBiase, but nonetheless, the contract was signed.
Yes, sir, certainly was. The bad thing about it, I hate that I let all the people in Georgia and around the country down because I thought I could beat the man.
Well, a lot
you
of
know,
people...
You know, excuse me, Tommy, I don't mean to interrupt, but I told the people here, and I was talking with Gordon, and I said the one thing that you'd said to me earlier, and that is that... you'd gotten a lot of encouragement from the fans. It's like right here we hear them, and you said to me that you were going to fight it. You're going to do whatever you could to make sure that you stayed in wrestling, and I know that's what I'd like to see. I know you'd like to see it, and I'm sure everybody all over the world would like to see Tommy Rich stay in wrestling.
Tommy, all we can do is wish you the very, very best, my friend.
Thank you very much, Gordon. We just have to wait and see what happens, but yeah, it's like I said time and again. I'm an old country boy, and whatever happens, just happens. I'll have to just wait and see.
For some time on today's program, and Mr. Ellering, I see you're wearing some rather unusual headgear.
You know, Gordon Solie, as 1983 draws to a close, everybody wants the precious one. Well, Buzz Sawyer, you cut some hair. Oh, yeah, you cut some hair. Well, big deal. The hair will always grow back. But Buzz Sawyer, I have a man called Joe LeDuc. And what he can do to you will not mend. It will not grow back. 1984, Gordon Solie, will be the year of the Legion of Doom. The Legion of Doom, I promise you, will get more tenacious than ever. With Stan Hansen, everyone is a thorn in the side of the precious one. And remember this, Buzz Sawyer, what does not kill me only makes me stronger. Revenge is a dish best served cold, and yours is going to be mighty cold indeed. Now I believe we have a film of my great champions, the Road Warriors.
Former champions.
My great champions, the Road Warriors, against a man from Texas. The bad man. Well, he ain't so bad anymore. And the Road Warriors are going to show everybody what bad is. Gordon Solie.
Well, if you wish to take a look at that particular match, I think we'll find it most interesting indeed. This took place at the Omni here in Atlanta. And as you can see, the Stan the Man Hansen from Borger, Texas. What are you doing in the ring, sir?
I'm merely pointing out to the referee the fact that Stan Hansen has been cheating this whole match.
trying to show to him that Stan Hansen was using a foreign object earlier in the match.
Well, obviously, Stan Hansen now in dire problems over on that far side. And again, I see Mr. Ellering moving into the ring and distracting the referee while Stan Hansen is being...
Distracting the referee? I'm merely trying to pull my Road Warriors away from this man, trying to save him from the humiliation of being beat like a dog. Nobody wants to see this big Stan Hansen beg like a dog, and I just wanted to save him some face.
Do you have any further comments, Mr. Ellery?
Yes, I do. 1984 finds Ronnie Garvin seeking Jake the Snake. Well, Ronnie Garvin, I got one thing to say to you. You better come up with a lot more money. A lot more money.
Mr. Garvin, I understand, is going to be here next week with a substantial amount of money to challenge for a chance at that television championship.
Well, he better. I just want to say one more thing. The wrath of Precious Paul will fall on World Championship Wrestling like death and taxes.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ellering, who seems to be sans some of the hair on his head at the moment. Let's go to the ring for this next match, please. Jake the Snake, the World Television Champion, moving out against Mike Jackson. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Jackson caught very quickly by Roberts in a side headlock. Well, I'll tell you one thing. I don't believe anybody should take the comments of Ellering lightly at all. He is a very determined individual and obviously can be a very dangerous individual. Jackson caught in that corner by Jake the Snake Roberts, and Jackson having that air supply driven out of his lungs. Irish whipped into the far turnbuckle. Jackson down and in trouble. Full body slam by Jake the Snake Roberts. Roberts then drives the knee into the side of the rib cage and then in the lumbar region of the back. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but Ellering is saying, go ahead, Jackson, quit. So Ellering ending 1983 on pretty much of a sour note. Jackson fires back, catches Jake the Snake, but it was ineffectual. And it is now Jake the Snake catching him in the throat once again. Got him in a bear hug coming off, and Jackson has his problems. Jackson. Intelligent competitor. Jake the Snake drives a right hand to the top of the head of Jackson. Drives him back to the canvas once again. Jake the Snake has him up. Backbreaker. And Jackson has his feet on the ring rope. And referee Scrappy McGowan warning Roberts. Can hear Ellering continuing his diatribe against Mike Jackson, continually agitating from the sidelines. Jackson with a forearm, another forearm, and then a quick takedown, and it is Jackson being caught by Jake the Snake Roberts once again. Jake the Snake using the back of the elbow very effectively into the side of the head. Jackson fires again to the midsection and again. There's plenty of fight in Mike Jackson, I'll guarantee you. Throw throat and crotch pickup by Jake the Snake Roberts. And Jackson powers out before the count of three, however. Jackson, again. Irish whip, and now look at Mike Jackson exploding. Mike Jackson giving it all he's got on Jake the Snake Roberts. And it's Jackson catching him with a beautiful drop kick. Jackson catches him with another drop kick, and Jake the Snake Roberts is in trouble. No question about it, Mike Jackson. Jackson, ooh. Went for a cross body block, and Jake the Snake Roberts rolling to one side. Jackson crashing down on that canvas. Ooh. Brought him up. It looked like he was going for a vertical souple, and then just threw his body into the center of the ring. The DDT. And that one jams the neck. The count of three. The count of three. And so Jake the Snake Roberts, the world television champion, prevails in his match against Mike Jackson. And he continues to collect interest on that $15,000.
You know, Gordon, I've taken my $15,000 body slam challenge all across this country, and all I've found is a bunch of pathetic, scrawny little geeks. I know somewhere out there there's got to be a man, some big weightlifter not afraid to come out of the gym, or some construction worker, or a tough truck driver, or somebody would like to take a shot at $15,000. All you got to do is slam 430 pounds King Kong Bundy. I want to find somebody out there in one of these towns with the guts to try it.
Thank you so very much. January 6th in Albany, Georgia, at the Civic Center. And, of course, Saturday, January 7th in Marietta. On Sunday, January 15th, 3 o'clock in the afternoon in Columbus, Georgia. And, of course, Sunday night, January 15th at the Omni here in Atlanta.
Very briefly, Tommy Rich, a legal contract was signed, and the law will prevail. I'm confident of that. As far as I'm concerned, Tommy Rich is like 1983, a thing of the past. Now, Buzz Sawyer, a week from today in Marietta, Georgia, you've been running your big mouth, talking about being the big, bad Buzz Sawyer, the dog, the mad dog Buzz Sawyer. Let me tell you something, Sawyer. I'm going to show you and all those people in Marietta that your bark is a lot worse than your bite. And I'm coming on tour. I'm going to Altoona. I'm going to Troy, Ohio. I'm going to Lansing, Michigan, all those places. You're going to see the best national champion.
Paul Ellering.
You know, Gordon Solie, wherever we go, the Legion of Doom leads the way. Albany, Georgia, we're coming your way in a sixth man. And from Albany, we travel all over the world to Wheeling, West Virginia, Altoona, you name it, we're going to be there.
You know, 1983 closed as Jake Shear as a champion. 1984, I'm going to try to answer a few questions for all the people. Why can anything be so rough and be so smooth? You tell me, brother. How can anything that's so hot, it'll be so hot in 1984, be so cold inside? People in Wheeling, Lansing, they'll all see what happens in 84, and I'll be right on top.
The ringside, I had not seen him yet earlier today. We're waiting for the Road Warriors, and there you see Bugsy shaking hands with and doing a dance with one of the young ladies at ringside. They're sitting next to Pat Monahan, and here he comes, I'll tell you what. Happy New Year.
Well, Gordon, so how are you doing?
Pretty good.
What side do you want?
Well, either way.
Just a few words, you know. It's going to be 1984. It's come right down to it. Road Warriors, uh-huh. You saw what the Road Warriors, what they did to Stan Hansen. What we're dealing with here is people that are oppressive, people that are going to try to take your dreams away from you, and people that want to ride roughshod over your, over the things you have, the things you want, and the dreams you have. But what I'm here to say, right here and right now, and believe me, I'm standing proud and tall, that the Road Warriors will not ride and be oppressive on me. If I get the chance, and all I'm asking for is a chance, is to face them in the ring, one-on-one or two-on-one. I'll find somebody, I don't care when or how or who,
but we're going to get it on. I don't care what size their arms are. I don't care if they paint their face. I don't care if they shave their head, brothers. And I'll tell you, people, this is just the same in my own profession. Don't let people take your dreams away from you. And Road Warriors, you've only begun to fight as soon as you start to face me. See you, Gordon. It's been sweet.
Okay, thank you so very much, Bugsy McGraw. But making some very, very heavy comments, I'll guarantee you the Road Warriors have got a lot to face in 1984 if a man like Bugsy McGraw has made up his mind to move out after them. Meanwhile, Garner and Jones are having their problems with the Road Warriors, the Animal and the Hawk. And this is not a question of will the Road Warriors defeat him, it's just a question of when will they defeat them, because and a forearm into the chest and another forearm into the chest. You can hear Ellering on the sidelines issuing comments once again. And so the Road Warriors completely dominating the situation. And Freddie Miller has just joined me.
Gordon, I hate to interrupt, and I hate to be the one to bring you this news, but we've just gotten the official word. Tommy Wildfire Rich will not be allowed to wrestle anymore. That's the official word. He will not.
Well, that is devastating news indeed, but I assume that they're looking at the legality of the contract, and that contract, apparently, the commission has found it indisputable, and certainly bad news indeed, a sad way to end 1983, to watch the demise of the career of Tommy Wildfire Rich. That was the word that we got from Freddie Miller, and, well, unfortunate. The Road Warriors completely decimating this team of Garner and Jones. Ole Anderson has joined me, and I think by the look on his face, he's as depressed as I am about that news about Tommy Rich.
I don't know what to say right now.
Well, that's an understandable situation, and it is the Road Warriors now continuing to punish this team of Garner and Jones. In the closing seconds that are remaining, may I just take an opportunity on behalf of World Championship Wrestling to say that it's certainly been a privilege for us to be in your homes for this past year. We hope that all of you do have a healthy, happy, and prosperous new year, and that you allow us to continue the privilege of coming into your homes each week. Got the pinfall. Well, I wonder what sort of legal moves are, or if there are any legal moves left for Tommy Rich.
Well, I really don't know. I think certainly the first thing to do is to try to contact the president, Bob Geigel, and I think to get the people that are on the board of directors and just see what kind of support we can drum up and do the best we can with it.
Because he's a man who obviously is, at this moment, very pleased.
Oh, Gordon Sully, I hear all of these people crying and sobbing and carrying on. But yes, it's true. The contract was valid. It was signed. Tommy Rich is finished. He can't wrestle. And all these people are crying and sobbing over it. Why cry? You've got the greatest wrestling machine that ever set foot in a square circle right here on World Championship Wrestling. And I'm not talking about Buzz Sawyer, and I'm not talking about any of these other goofs running around here. I'm talking about yours truly, Ted DiBiase, the National Heavyweight Champion. I promised you people that I would win the National Heavyweight title. I did. I promised you I'd hurt Tommy Rich. I did. And I promised you I would beat him and get rid of him. And just like 1983, he's gone. And I am here, Gordon Soley. And ladies and gentlemen, I am here to stay.
This match will be one fall with a 10-minute time limit. And, well, there's some sort of a discussion going on here. No, wait a second. Let's see what's going on. Thornton approaching the podium here.
Listen to me, Soley, and listen to me very careful. I'm sick of that bloody Ole Anderson jumping in my matches all the time. He's saying about his good boy is this, He's got a good boy who can beat me. His good boy should be the world champion. I've never seen Tommy Rogers do anything that puts anything over me. Not one thing. If Ole Anderson thinks he's so good, if Ole Anderson thinks he's so brilliant, why don't he take his little nappies off him and powder his behind and send him out here and let us wrestle in here today in that squared ring instead of just talking about it? Just let's see how good he is.
Well, I have no objection to, but we've got a scheduled match here, and,
I'm the scheduled match.
Yes.
I'll give the scheduled match up. Let's see this Tommy Lee Rogers come out here, and let's see how good he is. Have all the FC, all the time for Ole Anderson, how good my little boy is. He must carry a little diaper bag around with him, and pounding his behind all the time. Get him out here, and let's see how good he is. Let's see if he's good enough to take this belt off me.
Well, I can't just arbitrarily make a decision like that. However,
I'll make the decision. Let's have him here. If he's so good, Anderson, if he's so good, send him out here and let's see how good he is.
Well, Tommy isn't even scheduled to wrestle. I don't know if he is here. Perhaps we can get some word on that.
He's probably gone home to his mother.
Yep.
He's probably heard what I said. He's gone home to his mother. He's seen class. And when he sees class, he gets frightened. And I'm sick of all Anderson talking about class. I'm the class, not Anderson, Tommy Rogers. If Rogers wants it, let's get in there and let's get to it and let's get it done.
In other words, you're not going to wrestle this man. You're waiting for...
Why should I wrestle him?
Well,
it's Rogers that's doing all the shouting. It's Anderson that's doing all the shouting. Let's get him out of it. Don't let's talk about it. Let's get him out of it.
All right, well, I'll tell you what. We do have... Okay, all right. We do have a videotape and... let's go with that. Let's take a look at the Road Warriors in action at this particular time on videotape on the 7th in Marietta, Georgia, at the Cobb County Civic Center.
Yes, Marietta, Georgia. You know, I got a good friend, Bob Armstrong. Me and Bob Armstrong, we're going to come after the Road Warriors, you know, and we're going to just give it one heck of a fight, and we're going to defend these belts on tour, my brother and myself. And I'm looking for an exciting tour that's coming through.
You know, I'm looking for a lot of things. I'm looking for Ted DiBiase, Marietta, Georgia. Come on. That's what I owe you, DiBiase. You're out here running your mouth this whole last 2 hours with the Mad Dogs ready. I'm going to everywhere. I'm going up on tour. I'm going to... You know where I'm going, Gordon? All over the world.
The National Heavyweight Championship belt. And he is the man who has scored quite a coup in the... Pro ranks, DiBiase moving out against Mike Starbuck in the red trunks. DiBiase successful in putting Tommy Wildfire Rich out of wrestling. And Ole said he was going to be talking to Tommy and see if we can get him to come out and get some comments from him. I don't know that Tommy will. Also, notice Tommy Rogers is dressed out, so... No question in my mind that we're going to be seeing Rogers and Les Thornton. Rogers answering that challenge, I'm sure. So we'll see what happens on that. Meanwhile, DiBiase driving that knee repeatedly into the biceps and triceps of Starbuck. DiBiase. An arm bar on Starbuck. That can put some punishment on those deltoids. Starbuck gets it now. Had it back into the ropes, fires off. DiBiase caught him with a good shoulder smash, and it's DiBiase. Spin under takedown. DiBiase has all of the basics. DiBiase keeping the hammerlock on Starbuck. Ole Anderson is mentioning being up in Minnesota for the Christmas holidays. Brother, I'll tell you what, that entire Midwest has really been battered around by the weather this year, but it is Starbuck now who's taking the battering from one Ted DiBiase. Ole, were you able to convince Tommy Rich to come out, or would he rather not speak?
The way he is right now, he indicated that he would be out here a little bit later on, so we're looking forward to being able to have a few words with him. I just got through talking to the guy back in the dressing room there, the attendant, and I asked him if he wouldn't please get a hold of Tommy Rogers. He's indicated that he will wrestle Russ Thornton, well, as he comes out, I guess you can ask him yourself.
Tommy, I noticed you were dressed out just a couple of moments ago, so apparently you're answering the challenge.
That's right. I was in the back and listening to Les Thornton's comments, and he wants a match right here on nationwide TV. Well, if he wants a match, he's more than welcome to get a match with me, because I've been wanting to get him on this TV for a long time. And I'd like to prove to the people and to myself that I can beat Les Thornton.
Fair enough. Tommy Rogers answering the challenge, and so that'll be upcoming a little bit later on. We'll have to take a look at our schedule of matches here and see where we can get it in, but we'll get it in, that's for sure.
Well, Gordon, any match would be fine with me. You just let me know. I'll be in the back, and I'll be right out here and ready for action.
Fair enough. Tommy Rogers answering the challenge of World Junior Heavyweight Champion Les Thornton. Meanwhile, DiBiase brings Starbuck into the backbreaker. And didn't allow the pin. And I frankly think he had the man, Ole.
There's no question about it. DiBiase has just reached a new height and disgust, if nothing else. DiBiase is very, very happy with himself, certainly.
And again, did not allow the pin. You talk about achieving new heights or depths, whichever. Beautiful power slam. Got to give the man credit. He executes that power slam as well as anybody I've ever seen. Perfect execution, and so the National Heavyweight Champion, Ted DiBiase, is indeed victorious over Mike Starbuck. Challenge still holds.
You know, Gordon, you know what just disgusts me and makes me sick? It's when I look out of the crowd, into that audience, and see all those poor people, and I know how bad some of those boys could use my $15,000, and they don't have the guts to get in the ring. I'm telling anybody out there, all you concrete workers, all you truck drivers, all you big weightlifters, get in the ring and try to make yourself $15,000. If you've got the guts for it, I don't think any of you do. Devastation Incorporated, that money's sitting in my account, and it's going to stay there.
Thank you very much. Time limit. Let's go to the ring. Les Thornton, four times World Junior Heavyweight Champion. There you see him with the belt. He is from the British Isles, known as the man of 1,001 holes, an extremely versatile competitor. Won the championship for an unprecedented fourth time in Manila, in the Philippines. Tommy Rogers, also in the blue trunks, out of St. Petersburg, Florida originally, moves in, checked him out, collar and elbow. Thornton very quickly gets the side headlock. By the way, if we have to cut away to a commercial or anything during this match, should it go the full 20 minutes, we will, if a pinfall or a submission occurs, we will certainly bring it to you on instant replay. But right now, it's Thornton keeping Rogers tied up, and referee Scrappy McGowan checking those shoulders very quickly. This could be indeed a classic confrontation, Ole.
I'm sure. I've seen them wrestle before, as I mentioned. In fact, even thought for a moment that Tommy Rogers was going to be the new junior heavyweight champion. Apparently, that kind of talk and the thinking has gotten to Les Thornton, because I'm assuming that's what prompted him to say he's had enough and he wants to give Mr. Rogers a chance to see just how good he is. Well, I think Thornton knows, but Thornton's got a lot of pride, too. He's a tremendous amateur wrestler. He's a great professional wrestler. And, of course, he's been junior heavyweight champion four times. So he's got a record that speaks for itself. But now I think he's going to just have to show once again what he can do by defeating Tommy Rogers right here in the ring. This is his chance to do it.
And right now he's got Rogers in trouble as he's been punishing that left arm, keeping it in the hammerlock and driving the knee into it. Bottom wrist lock, lateral drop and takedown. And again, he has really put Rogers on the defensive so far.
Well, he's a little bit older. He's a little bit wiser. He's certainly got the experience over Tommy. Tommy's got the one thing that I really appreciate in a wrestler or a young athlete, and that is the desire and determination to do well. And Tommy's got it. He's like a Brett Wayne. He's like a Buzz Sawyer. He's like a Tommy Rich. The kind of kid that doesn't know the word the can't. Right there, you just see what he can do.
Yes, a beautiful spin under takedown, but it's Les Thornton going to the high head scissors. Both men back on their feet once again. Outstanding match thus far between these two. lock under, go behind by Thornton. Thornton with a waist lift takedown. Good escape by Tommy Rogers and into a reversal there as he gets the hammerlock on Les Thornton. There are very, very few men with the skills and capabilities of Les Thornton, but Tommy Rogers certainly has all of the desire in the world. And as we've said so many times, sometimes it's not the size of the man in the fight, it's the size of the fight in the man that makes the difference. Good counter by Thornton. Excellent counter. And again, Rogers finds himself on the receiving end and in a rather dangerous position, a momentary predicament. And now Rogers trying to battle his way back out, and Thornton again utilizing his weight and power. Good escape again by Rogers. Rogers doing some excellent counter wrestling. Martin. Beautiful high float over. And it is Rogers again finding himself in a defensive posture. Referee Scrappy McGowan having a relatively easy time of it right now because Thornton, there's where experience makes the difference. Thornton, percussion to the midsection and then two to the... And again, it's Rogers. And he has really got that down to a science. Rogers has that escape and counter move down to an absolute silence. And Rogers, moving in quick as a whippet, catches him again and definitely trying to take away the power of that left arm of Les Thornton.
Well, that's what he's got to do. He's got to stay on it. He's got to go ahead and immobilize some part of the body. And if he can do that, as we've said so many times, he then should have a decent chance of gaining a victory.
Bridge by Rogers, keeping those shoulders off. And again, Rogers back to that hammerlock. Thornton trying to counter, but
Made a mistake there. He's going into like an amateur, an armpit wrist breakdown type of thing, hooking that arm, bringing it back. But he just got overextended a little bit, and Thornton was able to grab a hold. But Tommy was able to come out on top again.
Nice counter again. And as I've said before, there are some men who are counter wrestlers, and Rogers and Thornton are both classic examples of counter wrestlers. And that means that the first one that gets in too deep and makes a mistake is going to find themselves pinned.
Well, in a match like this where both men are very capable wrestlers, and you can see the amateur style that they're using as well as combining it with professional style, one small mistake on anybody's part could result in that person losing the match.
Bolo-like forearm by Thornton, another one that rocks Rogers. And Rogers now could be in some trouble here as Thornton catches him again and again. And
I think they're just signaling Gordon. They're going to have to go in. Go ahead.
They're going to have to cut away, but should a pinfall or submission occur during the time we're away, we'll bring it to you an instant replay. We'll be back. We'll be back in just a moment. Neither man has been able to score a pinfall or a submission hold thus far, and both men carrying the battle to each other. There certainly has been no lack of aggression on the part of these two competitors. Up into a top wrist lock. Rogers exploding on him. And Thornton powered out from the lateral press, however. And it's Rogers. Ooh, brother, what a takedown by Thornton. A belly-to-belly takedown, and it is Rogers slipping away from it once again. Great, great action between these two. And it's Thornton taking his man down once again, almost had a pinfall on Tommy Rogers. Referee Scrappy McGowan watching. Brother, you talk about versatile competitors. These two are. And what an outstanding match we have seen thus far. Head scissors now by Tommy Rogers. He'll be trying to cut down that air supply if he can. And again, Thornton. That high end over, and it is Thornton going back to the arm, not even attempting the pin this time, but referee Scrappy McGowan down there nonetheless, checking those shoulders. Well, Rogers will have to keep those shoulders off the mat. And Thornton. Got Rogers over on his back. A dangerous position. Rogers very, very close to those ropes, and Thornton now punishing his man. And Rogers beginning to show fatigue here, trying to battle his way back up, and Thornton. Perhaps holds a slight edge in power. Beautiful move by Rogers. Excellent move. But look at how quickly Thornton recovered. Moved right back in on his man, utilizing his legs and his full body weight. Gets Rogers back to the canvas again. So he's making Rogers exert twice as much energy as Thornton has relied upon leaning on his man, so to speak. Gut-wrench salto by Thornton. And that made... No, sir. Rogers comes out of it again. And both men letting their tempers fly now. Rogers got him high across the head. Thornton was set and ready for him, though, and Rogers is stunned as he's dropped to the canvas. Deep, deep double underhook by Thornton. And it is... Rogers gets the pinfall. Rogers got the pinfall. Tommy Rogers got the pinfall over Les Thornton. Of course, that title was not on the line, but Rogers gets the pinfall. Tommy Rogers, there you see a very disgruntled Les Thornton, but Buzz Sawyer out there congratulating. Tommy Rogers, as Tommy Rogers proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that he can indeed pin the four times world junior heavyweight champion, Les Thornton. And a very, very disgusted Les Thornton. Well, there you see Thornton. Well, you can't see him. He's just out of camera range, but he's holding that belt. He still retains the belt. But let's take a look at it again in slow motion. You see what we're talking about. Beautiful deep double underhook by Thornton. And before Thornton could get over, it was a beautifully executed move by Tommy Rogers, scoring the pinfall.
I do not for the man with a thousand holes, and never will. Take a good look at this, Rogers, because this is the last time you'll ever see it. Because you could join the ranks of the has-beens, the ones behind me, the contenders, before you ever get this chance against me again. And as far as I'm concerned, you're finished, and you'll never wrestle me again.
Well, a bitter world champion.
Very well said by a very great champion. And I'll say this, it's a great match and it's a great victory, but can the boy do it when the title is on the line? That's when it counts. I heard Buzz Sawyer out here running his big mouth, talking about how I'm out here shooting off my mouth. Well, the one thing that eats you, Buzz Sawyer, and eats at everybody, is that I back up every word that I say. And in Marietta, Georgia, and around the tour, you're going to find out, Buzz Sawyer, that your bark's a whole lot bigger than your bite.
In Columbus, Georgia, at 3 p.m., wrestling will be held also Sunday night, January 15th, at the Omni here in Atlanta. And Mr. Ellering, of course, will be on tour.
You know, Gordon Solly, Precious Paul is seeing to give the fans the best in the champions, from the Road Warriors to Jake the Snake, from Wheeling, West Virginia to Altoona, Pennsylvania, from Lansing, Michigan to Marion, Ohio. It doesn't matter where the Legion of Doom goes. We own the ring. We own the four corners of doom, and we back up from no man. And as all you people know, Precious Paul, the genius of wrestling, will control all of it in 84.
National heavyweight champion Ted DiBiase, and as you can tell by the expression on his face, he's somewhat like the cat that swallowed the canary.
Well, Gordon Solie, why should I not be happy? I have fulfilled another agreement, you might say, a contract, you might say. I heard what you had to say. I've heard what Ole Anderson had to say, that it's just too bad about Tommy Rich, that maybe perhaps they'd have been happier if it had been me. Hey, the man signed a contract, and he stated that he would quit wrestling if he lost, and he lost. So why is everybody crying? I said I was going to do something. I did it. Tommy Rich is just like 1983. He's old news. He's old hat. Forget about him. All you people that are out there crying and weeping over Tommy Rich having to leave, hey, forget it. You want to send somebody cards and letters and everything? Send them to me. Send them to a champion that you can admire and you can look up to, because I'm the national heavyweight champion, and I'm going to be that way for a long, long time.
Wrestling will be held this coming Friday night in Albany, Georgia, at the Civic Center, and next Saturday night, championship wrestling will be coming to Marietta, Georgia.
Gordon Soley, I heard Buzz Sawyer out here calling me a big bag of hot air that I'm shooting off my big mouth, telling people I'm doing this and doing that. What's eating you, Buzz Sawyer, is that I've done everything that I said I was going to do. I got rid of Tommy Rich. I won the National Heavyweight Championship, took it off your brother, and then Marietta next week I'm going to get a piece of you, too.
It's taking quite a bit of credit, I might add, for a rather ignominious defeat of one Stan Hansen.
You know, Gordon Soley, Stan Hansen is a big man. I'll give him credit. And he comes from a big state. But Stan Hansen, did you ever stop and think that's why a lot of people come from that state? Maybe because it's people like you live there. You redneck, big old Texan. Oh, yeah, you're a big boy, but what'd you do against the Road Warriors, huh? I felt good, Gordon Soley. I felt so very good when my Road Warriors demonstrated just what tenacity is about.
I wonder if you'd care to doff your chapeau for just a moment, sir.
Gordon Soley, I've given you credit for being a brilliant man. And the reason you're a brilliant man is because you recognize a genius. You recognize the fact that I'm a genius. For me to take off this hat and make, oh, everybody's laughing. You think it's a big deal, huh? Oh, Precious Paul got his hair cut. Buzz Sawyer cut his hair. Well, it's no big deal. It's no big deal. The hair will grow back. The Precious Paul will reign supreme. The wrath of Precious Paul, Gordon Soley, is more than life itself. And there's a lot of wrestlers that better realize that, starting with old Stan Hansen. You got Stan Hansen, the blowhard from Blowhard, Texas. You got old Anderson, the mouth that wouldn't die. You got Buzz Sawyer, Spot, running around saying, oh, yes, Paul Ellering is going to get a haircut. Well, I got a haircut. You promised the people, yes, I got a haircut. Buzz Sawyer, to me, you'll always be Spot, and I took you to the top. And where you're at right now, it's on the bottom as far as I'm concerned. Tommy Rich. Tommy Rich. Somebody asked me, what's good about Tommy Rich? I couldn't think of anything either. Well, he's gone. We don't have to worry about you anymore, Tommy Rich. As far as I'm concerned.
Thanks for watching the best of championship wrestling. The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated.
And welcome to another hour of... And brother, do we have the action for you. Later on in the program, we're going to be seeing the NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair. We'll be talking to Wahoo McDaniels. The Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant, is here, and a host of others. Right now, though, let me bring in Ole Anderson, because something is, something that's concerning everybody. The latest sports review, the 1984 annual, has on the front cover Tommy Wildfire Rich. And a really an ironic twist of events that he would be selected for that cover when it looks like now he's not going to be able to wrestle.
Well, I'll tell you what, Ted DiBiase, of course, is happy. He's telling everybody that he's managed to get Tommy Rich out of wrestling. Well, legally speaking, Tommy Rich, I guess, isn't going to be able to wrestle. But I'll tell you, we all know that sometimes there are people that do things that either just aren't quite according to the letter of the law. And in this case, if Tommy Rich were to do something that wasn't just quite according to the letter of the law, I don't think there'd be anybody in the world that would blame him. So I'm saying this to you, Ted DiBiase. Maybe you just kind of better watch your backside.
Yeah, because there may be something about his wrestling professionally, but I don't think that would stop Tommy from catching him in an alley or anything else.
Well, there's lots of possibilities, and I'm certain that Tommy has been thinking about them all, and I think that the people all around the country better keep their eyes open. Better watch, and most importantly, I think DiBiase better watch.
May I make a point on that? Although, allegedly, Tommy is cannot wrestle, that doesn't mean that he can't buy a ticket and go anywhere the DiBiase is,
well,
does it?
You've just kind of let the cat out of the bag. There's a definite possibility. Certainly, anybody can buy a ticket. Well, let's let Mr. DiBiase kind of think about that for a second. You know, people have been writing in here all the time, Gordon, talking about wanting to see a lot of great wrestlers on the TV program, and we've always said that World Championship Wrestling is the greatest program in the world today. Today, I think we're going to just outdo ourselves because we've got a lot of great wrestlers. You're going to see Wahoo McDaniel. You're going to see the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant. You're going to see the world heavyweight champion, Ric Flair. You're going to see the national champion. You're going to see a lot of people. And right now, Gordon, I think you might introduce the people in the ring because people gave him a heck of a rousing hand, and I think they're real anxious to see him wrestle.
Well, there are two people coming back home, so to speak. We're talking about Bob and Brad Armstrong, and they're facing a tough combination in Roger Bond and in Chick Donovan. There you see them in the ring getting set to go. Bob Armstrong moving out. Roger Bond and Chick Donovan, the golden boy. Bob Armstrong, of course, out of Marietta, Georgia. He's been under takedown by Bond, but Armstrong turns that around to his own advantage very quickly. Makes a quick tag with Brad Armstrong. Brad Armstrong overhooks, and Bob Armstrong is completely and totally aggressive.
You're exactly right. You look at Brett and Bob, you're looking at a heck of a tag team, one that knows how to wrestle, knows how to work in combination, and they get the job done. And I'm certain that Mr. Bond and Mr. Dunham are going to find themselves, they're going to have their hands full.
Keeping a side headlock on Bond. Bond trying to make that tag with Chick Donovan, makes a tag. Donovan moves in. Donovan extremely well-muscled and a very powerful individual. They lock up collar and elbows. Donovan getting a quick advantage here with a full-arm drag and twist. Bottom wrist lock, a lateral drop and takedown into a float-over lateral press. And it is Brad Armstrong back on his feet. Chick Donovan closes in. Back to the side headlock. Nice to have Pat Minahan back with us today. And my thanks to her for the carnation. And so, tag is made and Bond moves back in, and it is Brad Armstrong very quickly tagging up with Bob Armstrong. Bob Armstrong. Bob looks like, and he's always had an extremely powerful upper body, but he looks like he's bulked up even a little more.
I think so. Bob tells me that he's up around 245 now, and the way he looks, those big arms and shoulders, that's 245 well distributed on that 6'1" frame of his. And of course, Brad, he's just really a young boy growing all the time, and he's looked like he's put on 10 or 15 pounds. And look, what coordination between the two of them, the teamwork, you might have.
Almost had a pinfall that time, and it is Bond firing the midsection. Brad Armstrong firing back, then catches the forearm to the side of the head. Another forearm, and that was along the ear, and that lost his balance, took him off his feet.
I was going to say, what happens, or what could happen? Can you imagine all the possibilities against the Road Warriors? You've got the Sawyers, Brett and Buzz. You've got the Armstrongs. I think that we may still find somebody to take care of those Road Warriors.
I think you have an excellent point there, and caught him. By the way, I understand that Ronnie Garvin's raised some money, and so we'll be having him up later on to find out that TV title match.
Well, Garvin was told by Ellering to come up with some money, and we would be able to have a TV title match. I see Snake is going to be on TV today. So it's quite possible that we'll be seeing Jake the Snake, national television champion, accept that money from Ronnie Garvin and give him a chance at that title shot. Should be interesting.
Should be indeed. We've got a standoff here now as Brad Armstrong closes in, each man testing each other for strength and leverage. And it's Brad Armstrong looking like he might be getting just a slight bit of advantage here. Donovan. Great battle between these two, but it's Brad Armstrong upending him, and he makes the tag with Roger Bond. Roger Bond moving back into the ring against Brad Armstrong. Collar and elbow back into the turnbuckle. Tag is made. Bob Armstrong moves in. The Armstrongs do have that teamwork down, no question about it. They're a well-oiled machine once they get into the ring. There's a full Nelson by Bob Armstrong.
See, we've got the photographers here from Pro Wrestling and Sports View Wrestling at ringside. And of course, anytime you've got those photographers, you can rest assured they're here to cover the important things that take place in wrestling, and we're happy to have them.
No question about it. And they don't just make a staff assignment on this one. They send in their senior editor, Bill Apter, and also Craig Peters, two outstanding gentlemen. And all right, Brad Armstrong, caught in the midsection by Bond. Dick Donovan exploding on Armstrong could have him in trouble. The Golden Boy has things going his way. Donovan has Armstrong down. For the first time in this match, it looks like Armstrong's are indeed in trouble. Donovan smashing him into the turnbuckle. So Donovan, who's taken a lot of punishment, now suddenly returning that punishment. Brad Armstrong powers out, but he would be well served, I think, to get over and tag up as Donovan catches him with a full body slam. Good move, Armstrong, and a good block. Donovan powers out very quickly, tags up with Bond. Brad Armstrong tags up with Bob, and Bob Armstrong catches both Donovan and Bond. Cross body block. Beautiful move, excellent. Cross body block, and it is indeed the Armstrongs, Bob and Brad Armstrong, who are victorious. So this is a blood feud if there ever was one. And Rich didn't even wait for DiBiase. He cleared the ring, and that's about it. And we've got a Pier 6. We've got a Pier 6er going here. A family fight if you've ever seen one. DiBiase is in trouble. The National Heavyweight Champion is in trouble. As Johnny Rich, the cousin of Tommy Rich from Tennessee, is putting a pounding on him. But now, brother, what a dogfight.
I'll tell you what, there's no love lost here. DiBiase thought he got rid of all the riches. Johnny Rich said he wanted a match, and World Championship Wrestling was more than happy to give him a match right here on TV. DiBiase, I think, thinks he's just going to go out there and lord it over everybody, but he's finding out that Johnny Rich just isn't going to lay down for him.
Hot and beautifully coming over. He may have him. One, two, no. DiBiase rolls from the ring. DiBiase giving it some second thought here. And you see Bill Apter behind getting pictures of this match. Well, DiBiase's giving this one some second thoughts.
Well, he better think about it. You know, we were mentioning before about the possibilities that are open to Tommy Rich. We didn't even mention the fact that Tommy's got the cousin, Johnny Rich, and it doesn't look as though Johnny is just going to be sitting in the back either. There's nothing that's going to prevent Johnny from coming ringside. He doesn't have to buy a ticket. He can get right in there, and he's doing a heck of a job right now, Mr. DiBiase.
DiBiase's got his problems as Johnny Rich. Oh, that's a beautiful drop kick. And a frustrated national champion leaves the ring again. Ted DiBiase completely frustrated. Of course, you've got to watch him. He is also breaking the momentum of Johnny Rich. He's thinking. He's an intelligent competitor.
You know, I think about Ted DiBiase, and I see Johnny up there. It reminds me of a game that I watched just recently, Miami and Nebraska. Nebraska came in. Nobody even could come close to them. And that's kind of like Ted DiBiase. It seems like nobody can come close to him. Well, maybe Johnny Rich is just like Miami, and we might just see an upset here.
Good do indeed, and it is DiBiase getting a slight edge here at the moment as he's punishing Johnny Rich in the turnbuckle.
I've been in a situation at times where I was a little bit concerned about what I might do after having gone the ring overconfident. And you can look at Ted DiBiase right now. He's got the belt. And even though the belt's not at stake in this match, he certainly is well aware that if he would lose this match to Johnny Rich, he's going to have a lot of people thinking that he's lost it. And right now, he's trying to figure out where did he go wrong. He realizes he's smart enough. He's got a lot of experience. He's got more experience than Johnny's got. He's bigger than Johnny. His even wrestling ability, obviously because he's a champion, I'm assuming has to be better. But right now, he's trying to figure out what in the world can I do to stop this kid that seems to have everything going for him.
DiBiase stunned that time, and again, DiBiase leaves the ring. A study of complete rage and frustration. And Rich wants some more of him. Rich, really fired up. Well, Kathy Minshew in Jonesboro is watching. Right now, she has to be pretty pleased at the way Johnny Rich is handling Ted DiBiase, the national heavyweight champion. Take care of those eyes, Kathy. Johnny Rich moving effectively on Ted DiBiase. DiBiase a step ahead that time. DiBiase definitely a step ahead that time. Caught Rich in the pit of the stomach. And that one caught him completely off guard. DiBiase drives a knee. And DiBiase now resorting to any tactic available to him, being warned by the referee, Scrappy McGowan. And Scrappy McGowan laying some heavy words on DiBiase. DiBiase punishing Rich on the ropes. Breaking before the count of four. He doesn't want to risk a disqualification here. Lateral press by DiBiase, and Rich now. Rich has been slowed appreciably. DiBiase caught him with an elbow. Rich powers out once again. DiBiase misses. Rich caught him. Good move by Johnny Rich, but DiBiase again powers out. Rich catches him in the midsection, coming in, catches him again in the midsection. And Rich now retaliating. Rich getting it together. Rich with a series of lefts and rights. DiBiase back to his feet, and it's Rich once again. Good drop kick by Johnny Rich. DiBiase powers out, but just barely. Rich may have it here. The sweet smell of victory may be in Rich's nostrils right now. He catches DiBiase, but brother, can this DiBiase take it? You gotta give him credit. The man can take. Ooh. Rich caught right in the midsection again. He got it. He got it. Well, it was experience there. Experience there that paid off, but he barely got by with that one. Right now, here's a special word.
15th, 8:30, a sensational card. It'll be Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer taking on one of wrestling's strongest, toughest, meanest men, Big Joe LaDuke. National Heavyweight Championship, Ted DiBiase, champion, against Marietta, Georgia's Bob Armstrong. Six-man tag, the Road Warriors and Killer Carl Krupp against Jerry Briscoe, Brett Wayne, and Bugsy McGraw. TV title, Jake the Snake Roberts, champion, takes on the King of Wrestling, Jerry Lawler. Ron Garvin clashes with Pistol Pez Watley. Tommy Rogers against Brad Armstrong, winner to meet Les Thornton for the world's junior heavyweight title. Plus other matches including King Kong Bundy's challenge to Atlanta for $15,000. That's the Omni in Atlanta, January 15th.
And there's great wrestling tonight in Marietta at the Cobb County Civic Center. Match time is 8:30. That's tonight in Marietta. And, of course,
that's right. And I can't wait. Ted DiBiase, I'm coming to Marietta tonight. I'm coming for you. Then I'm starting on tour. I'm going to Marietta, Ohio. I'm going to Lansing, Michigan. I'm going to Pennsylvania, Altoona. I'm going all over the place. And I'm looking for anybody that wants to wrestle the Mad Dog. But DiBiase, tonight, it's you and me.
I'm from New York City.
Gomez hit the ring, and Garner struck him the minute he got inside. And brother, the Boogie Woogie Man is on. He is on. There's no question about it. And it's a Boogie Woogie Man. He'll fair six it if you want. And that's exactly what Mr. Garner's beginning to find out right now. It's over. It is over. Jimmy Valiant, the Boogie Woogie Man, turns back Paul Garner in almost record time. Boogie Man, luscious Jimmy Valiant, just set a new single pin record time. There you see it, 24:45. 24:45, single pin record time for the Boogie Woogie Man. Precious Paul Ellering has joined me here at the desk. And I understand that Mr. Garvin does have some money collected and is ready to take on Jake.
I heard you, Gordon. You're standing out here throwing figures out. Well, I heard Ronnie Garvin has a figure. What is your figure, Ronnie Garvin?
Well, I'm going to tell you something. You know, being Christmas, I spent a lot of money. Coming up with a lot of cash is kind of hard. But I tell you, I came up with $4,350, and I think it's quite sufficient for a title match.
$4,350? You got to be kidding. Are your brains scrambled or what? Hey, don't touch me. I'm managing, Garvin. I'm not.
You're right here on television. Nobody's ever done it, but I might be just able to do that.
Listen, Garvin, you've given new meaning to the word cheapskate. $4,350.
Right.
You're joking. You should be ashamed for even coming out here.
$4,350. That's a lot of money.
That's peanuts. Peanuts, Garvin. You know. You must have been struck dumb, or did it come naturally? I said big money, Garvin. I'm talking big money. $4,350. That's for peons. That's for 8-to-5 lifers, Garvin.
What kind of money do you want, sir?
Let me see. Let's just throw out a figure and say $35,000.
$35,000? This guy's got to be a nut.
Hey,
where can I come up with 35? We're talking about $4,350, and I think it's plenty.
We're talking about the king of cable. We're talking about the national TV championship. We're talking about a belt that millions of people watch every week.
And I know exactly how much money it's worth and what the prestige that goes with it. But I'm going to tell you something. The only thing you're going to get out of me is $4,350, and I think it's plenty. The only reason your man is a champion is because you're out of fear. And I'm going to give you the $4,350 anytime. But $35,000, you got to be out of your mind.
$35,000, Garvin. Come up with it or no match. $35,000, I don't care how you do it.
I'm going to come up with $35,000 cash.
You got a house, don't you?
Yeah, that's going. I'm going to keep my house, believe me.
Sell your house, Garvin. If you want the match that bad, sell your house.
How much time do you give him?
I'll give you 2 weeks. I'll give you 2 weeks, Garvin.
You got 2 weeks.
And just to show you, Garvin, that I'm not playing around, that nobody's messing around. I mean what I say. I got a match with the Road Warriors. And there again, Stan Hansen, and, well, you're about half the size of Stan Hansen. Watch what they do to him. $35,000.
Let's take a look.
That's right, $35,000. You are what you are, Garvin. You're cheap. Cheap!
Well, you're talking about the Road Warriors, and we're seeing them in action right now. And, of course, you've got a two-on-one situation here.
Well, naturally, Gordon, they were tagging out. You got a five count. They're able to do anything they can within the count of five, and that's all that they did. Stan Hansen and his partner, whoever he was, the nobody from No Dome, was in there. They did the same thing previously, so we were just paying back.
And what are you doing in there, sir?
I'm merely trying to point out to the referee how Stan Hansen was cheating in the previous portion of this match. About the first 5 minutes of this match, Stan Hansen did nothing but cheat. I'm finally coming in there, pointing out to the referee the rules as stated by Bob Geigel and the NWA.
I see. But
I'm trying to pull my Road Warriors off to save this man from humiliation. They're beating him like a dog. Nobody wants to see this big man cry and beg. I'm saying leave him alone. Let the man be. And as you can see, we ain't fooling around. 1984 will belong to the Legion of Doom.
But they do have 2 weeks now. Ronnie Garvin's got two weeks.
That's all he got. He better sell his house or think of something else.
All right, he's got 2 weeks to try and raise $35,000 if he wants that national TV championship match. Right now, let's go to the ring. We've got Bret Sawyer getting set to move out against Pat Rose. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Very special happy birthday to Cresha Allen and to her aging father, Ron Allen, who also had a birthday. Bret with a front chancery. Beautiful takedown, but Rose powers out of it. Good ride by Bret Wayne. Keeps the ride moving. Full arm drag and twist now by Bret Wayne. And Rose caught with a head scissors in a takedown. I mentioned Pat Minahan. I'd also like to mention Diane Bachman from Marshall, Wisconsin here. And Jerry Moore from Marshall, Wisconsin. Their hearts, they're down here watching the matches. Collar and elbow once again. Bret Wayne gets the good reversal by Rose. Full arm drag and twist. Buzz Sawyer at ringside watching his younger brother very, very intently. Head scissors. And Bret suffering from some previous injuries and beginning to show that now in this match. He's taken some percussions to the head and it's beginning to take a toll on him. This could begin to obscure his vision slightly, and that could create some additional problems. Keeping Pat Rose tied up. Side headlock by Rose now keeps Bret Wayne in trouble. Wayne fires him off. Hip toss. That's what had Rose in trouble. Rose charges again, catches him with another arm drag. Rose started to slip from the ring and suddenly saw Buzz Sawyer there and thought better of it. Waist inch forward leg trip by Wayne. All right, he's got the pressure on Pat Rose now. It's going to be Rose's job to try and get away from that kind of pressure. Bret Wayne. Great intensity, of course. He and Buzz Sawyer, the national tag team champions, and Wayne has shown Rose the way to go, but it's been a tough battle thus far.
Well, you see that Bret is just a tremendous wrestler. We know that. We've watched him come from the time that he was just wrestling in some of the early matches to the point where now he's won half of the National Tag Team Championship combination along with Buzz. Bret is a gutsy kid. He's a heck of a wrestler. And right now you see the evidence, he's been lacerated rather severely on his head. And even that doesn't stop Brett Wayne from competing.
The only thing I was concerned about is it may be causing a vision problem, but now he bulldogs his man. And problem is, Rose is still able to power out. Good clean break, steps back. Both men eyeing each other again very carefully. They move in, collar and elbow. Brett Wayne, Brett Sawyer gets that side headlock to the hip lock takedown. Rose trying to turn that to his own advantage. Brett Wayne powers back. Well, like you said, there are some powerful tag team combinations. It wouldn't surprise me if the Armstrongs challenge him.
Oh, no question about it. A possible match between the Sawyers and the Armstrongs, I'm sure, would draw a lot of people anyway. Certainly, now that Brett and Buzz have those national tag team champions, they're going to be fair game for anybody. We talk about the Road Warriors a lot being number one in line, but certainly there are an awful lot of other combinations. Certainly the Briscoe brothers, Jack and Jerry, would be a combination. Possibly the Funks, Terry and Dory Funk. Steamboat and Youngblood. There's just a lot of combinations. I see, well, later on we're going to be talking to Wahoo McDaniel here and NWA champion Ric Flair. Now, I don't know who Wahoo will be teaming up with now, but certainly anytime he gets in the ring, he's an electrifying performer, a great wrestler, probably one of the greatest athletes of all time. And if he were to take most anybody as a partner, I'm sure that he would make a heck of a challenge for those national heavyweight titles.
No question about it. My first thought right away came to my mind is the Boogie Woogie Man.
Well, I didn't mean, I'll tell you, you know, when we start talking about the various people that are here in World Championship Wrestling, you start mentioning 5, 6, 7, then 10, 12, 15, and pretty soon before you know it, you still left a few people out.
Exactly, exactly, no question about it. Tied him up very nicely. He's got the figure four, Pat Rose conceding. Pat Rose conceding to the figure four. So a fine victory for Brett Sawyer, a hard-fought victory. Pat Rose, a very durable, very, very fine competitor. And I'll guarantee you that he is double tough indeed. I want to take a moment to talk to Okay, so Jake the Snake not accepting the $4,350 challenge of Ronnie Garvin. Paul Ellering has given Garvin 2 weeks to get up $35,000. So it's Mike Jackson moving out against Jake the Snake Roberts. Roberts, of course, the television champion. Johnny Rich has joined me, and I can pretty well imagine what he's got on his mind.
Well, Gordon, you know, I'm not going to sit back there in the back and hang my head, you know. Even the best get beat. Just look what happened to Nebraska, you know, this past week. That shows you even the best can get beat sometime at another. But all I want to say is, DiBiase, it's going to take a lot more than that, brother, to get rid of me. I'm not quitting. You won't see me quitting no time, brother, because I ain't a quitting bone in my body. And also, if you think you got rid of Tommy Rich, brother, just be looking around. Just think every time you look behind your shoulder, because he's going to be there one way or the other. You may not notice it, DiBiase, but he's going to be there. So just remember that, brother. You're not going to get rid of us. No time soon, brother. No time.
Thank you so very much, Johnny Rich. Very determined young man. All right, Paul Ellering making some comments to Mike. Jackson will show you the way to go. I'll guarantee you that. He is a tough young man. Talking to my good friend, the singer, musician, composer, Bertie Higgins, and producer Sonny Limbo the other day. Yeah, hopefully we'll have him on here one day, but they were commenting about the fact that Jackson, great speed, great skill, great ability, and gives away anywhere from 40 to 140 pounds every time he steps in the ring, and that takes a very, very special kind of courage. Jackson keeps the side headlock on Jake the Snake Roberts.
Ooh.
High backdrop, and Jackson came right down on the brother. That took a jar. Snake taking every advantage possible now. Jackson hurtled into that turnbuckle, and Jackson hurtled again. Jackson down. Jake the Snake Roberts may start to have things pretty well under control now. And again, a high backdrop. And with Roberts being better than 6 feet 4 inches tall, Jackson gamely fires back to the midsection. Good move by Jackson. Roberts able to break it up, however. Tried for a rolling reverse. High knee lift by Jake the Snake Roberts. Brings this man up. Ooh, the DDT. It's over, I'll guarantee you. It is indeed. Mike Jackson in a game fight. But couldn't withstand the DDT, and now here's a very special word.
Buzz Sawyer taking on one of wrestling's strongest, toughest, meanest men, Big Joe LaDuke. National Heavyweight Championship, Ted DiBiase, champion against Marietta, Georgia's Bob Armstrong. Six-man tag, the Road Warriors and Killer Carl Krupp against Jerry Briscoe, Brett Wayne, and Bugsy McGraw. TV title, Jake the Snake Roberts, champion, takes on the King of Wrestling, Jerry Lawler. Ron Garvin clashes with Pistol Pez Watley. Tommy Rogers against Brad Armstrong, winner to meet Les Thornton for the world's junior heavyweight title. Plus other matches including King Kong Bundy's challenge to Atlanta for $15,000. That's the Omni in Atlanta, January 15th.
On the front cover of Wrestling 1984 annual, Tommy Rich. Tommy Rich is a thing of the past. His cousin's out here, and Gordon Solie, you and Ole Anderson telling everybody, telling Ted DiBiase, you better look out for Tommy Rich. Tommy Rich is going to get you. Well, Tommy Rich, if you can buy an airplane ticket and come to Altoona, Pennsylvania, Marion, Ohio, Charleston, West Virginia, will you come on down? You buy a ticket and come in the arena. Buy all the tickets if you got to, and come down to that ring, and I won't just beat you and run you off like I have now. I'll finish you off, Rich. And as far as Buzz Sawyer out here, the bulldog barking like a big dog, tonight in Marietta, Sawyer, I'm going to show you you're nothing but a chihuahua. And last but not least, Bob Armstrong, just like Tommy Rich in the Omni on the 15th, Armstrong, I'm going to show you you're a thing of the past.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. The national champion may be in for more trouble than he's bargained.
Hey, isn't it nice, Gordon? Doesn't it always look good with me? I'll tell you something. You know, I'm going on tour, Gordon. There's a lot of fools out there that seem to think they can beat me. Well, you got 10 minutes. So it doesn't matter if you're in Troy, Ohio, Lansing, Michigan, Altoona. It doesn't matter. Even in the Omni, I hear somebody call the king is coming. The king should have stayed home with the queen. Don't you know that,
brother? But no shenanigans from you.
Really? We'll see.
$15,000 challenge to any one of you who can body slam him. And that starts tonight, of course, in Marietta.
That's right, Gordon Solie. I'll be in Marietta, the $15,000 challenge. I'll be in the Omni January 15th. I'm taking the challenge on tour. I'm going to Troy, Ohio, Lansing, Michigan, Altoona, Pennsylvania. All you big weightlifters, all you tough construction workers, anybody's got the guts to get in the ring and body slam King Kong Bundy. $15,000, boys. Think about it.
Here's a special word. Wow, the Road Warriors attacking their opponents before anybody even got a chance to get a bell rung or anything else. And now the two of them on Mike Starbuck and the big man in red trying to get back in the ring. Wait a minute, what happened here? Wait a minute. Ronnie Garvin just hit the ring. Ronnie Garvin just hit the ring, and brother, is he flying? And he's handy with those dukes as well. Garvin A stinging right hand. Garvin ducks away. Another stinging right hand. Garvin closes in. And so Garvin has indeed taken the place of Big Red. Road Warrior has him up. Full breath above his head. As Garvin slips away from that. Tied for a pinning combination, and he's got the Hawk and the Animal upset. And Garvin fighting fire with fire. And he's showing him the way to go. He misses, and it's Garvin connecting. Garvin really moving on these Road Warriors. And again, they miss, and Garvin connects again. Garvin, a beautiful counterpuncher.
I'll tell you, you look at Garvin in there, if there's any question about what he might be able to do, it should all be dispelled now, looking at him in the ring. There's a question. Mr. Roberts doesn't want to wrestle Garvin for that TV title. Ellering's got it up to $35,000, tell him to sell his house. Well, the way we see Garvin right now, I don't blame Ellering for putting a high price tag on it. He probably made it too low, because if Garvin can get up with that money, Garvin just might get that belt if he wrestles like he's wrestling right now.
And he'd make that money back in a hurry.
He sure would, as a national television champion. $35,000 would come to him pretty quick.
Road Warriors now have Starbuck in the ring, and they catch him with the back of the elbow. And now the Road Warriors beginning to dominate the situation once again.
Here's the only problem. Before, when Starbuck was around, Garvin tried to get him out. Now Garvin is calling for him and trying to get him back over the tag. Starbuck has got to tag. He's got to let Garvin come back in there. Garvin's got to carry the weight.
All right, Starbuck is needed to give Garvin that much-needed rest, but get that second win going. But he needs now, and I think the Road Warriors are aware of it. They're doing everything they can to keep Starbuck from getting over the top. Starbuck, Meltzer went to the wrong corner. The wrong corner now makes the tag. Ronnie Garvin back into the ring, and Garvin again. A stinging right hand, another one, and then a boot to the midsection. Caught him. Across the head.
Starbuck knew what he had to do. Garvin was calling him. Garvin said, tag out. Starbuck was confused, and I don't know how he did it, but he looked up, and he saw he was in the wrong spot and turned around, and he was lucky enough to make that tag.
All right, Ronnie Garvin now, the full-arm dragon twist. And the Hawk reverses that, and Garvin could be in trouble here. Ducks to one side and very quickly makes the tag. And that gives Starbuck a little added chance here. Meanwhile, Garvin gets a chance to get his breath back. The Animal moves in now against Mike Starbuck. And again, Garvin watching and obviously at this point in time hoping that... the Road Warriors have Starbuck in trouble here. He needs very desperately to tag up with Ronnie Garvin. Tag is made. And wait a second, Garvin charges in. He doesn't like the double teaming. Starbuck, the legal man in. Hawk brings him up, presses him over his head. Full slam once again. And Starbuck having a lot of trouble getting up.
Don't forget, when this match is over, we're going to be seeing Walt McDaniel and Rick.
That may have all but broken his neck. It's all over. It is all over. And so the Road Warriors continue their victorious ways. Well, in just a moment, we're going to be seeing the man who is featured on the latest upcoming issue of Pro Wrestling Illustrated. The twice NWA World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. And we're going to be having Ric Flair with us in just a moment, along with Chief Wahoo McDaniels. Welcome back, sir.
Good to be back. You know, we're down here looking around, you know, looking for competition. You know, we're like you and everybody else in the United States. We're watching Channel 17, and I see DBS here. I see Jake the Snake Roberts. And you know, we've come down here, I've come down here looking around for a little competition, which I don't think I'll have a hard time finding. The Road Warriors. I'd like to get me a partner. I don't care who it is. I don't seem to think that I'll have a trouble getting me a partner. But I got to say one thing. They're impressive. DiBiase, I'll listen to you. I'll watch you talk. But like I said, I came down here. I'm just scoping everything out. Slater, Orton, you know that I'm looking for you. And you know...
Good to see you.
And the NWA World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair.
You know, as Wahoo said, everybody's got their eyes on Channel 17. A lot happened in the wrestling world. And when you're the world champion, you respond to the call because you like to meet the best head-on. So DiBiase, Sawyer, it makes no difference. Jake the Snake Roberts, Orton, Slater, Valentine. If you want to be the man, you come downtown and try and beat the man because you are looking at the World Heavyweight Champion, the greatest wrestler of all time, and the greatest sports announcer of all time, Mr. Gordon Solie, side by side, styling and profiling.
Woo! Professional wrestling, Joe LaDuke is on his way.
There's no question about it, and I'm certain that there's all the evidence in the world that a guy by the name of Paul Ellering might be behind it, because I can't think of anybody else that would bring anybody in that's as mean and as nasty as Joe LaDuke. And we've got something to show the people. LaDuke is not only a tremendous wrestler, but he's got the strength of about 10 men, as you'll see here when we watch this film.
We're going to watch him rolling a 10-ton bus, and then you're going to see others' examples of the strength and the desire of this man, Joe LaDuke.
You know what interests me the most? All of you that's watching this beautiful network, and I watch this network too, and I watch Bud Sawyer, and I watch Bret Sawyer, and I watch Bugsy McGraw, and who else do I watch? But anyway, Bud Sawyer, let me say this to you, brother. You know, you call yourself Mad Dog Sawyer. That's cute. That's real fine. You're in the Big A, not the Big Apple, the Big Atlanta, where the people are supposed to be tough, according to this Channel 17. Well, where I come from, you know, when I was born, they didn't milk me, brother. They give me beer. And when I cut tray at 72 below zero, I don't have to complain because I don't get cold. Buzz Sawyer. You think you're a mad dog, yeah? Have you ever been bit?
Look out!
Joe LaDuke is back. And I'm not crazy like everybody thinks.
The only thing cold about that man's his heart.
He's a tough guy. There's no question about it. You see him at the very end. He picks up a wrestler and throws him on top of the table over the top of the ring. And at the very beginning, you saw him pull, as you say, a 10-ton bus. There were all kinds of reporters and people there at the time to watch that. Joe LaDuke is an incredibly strong man. He's a very tough man. And we'll just have to wait and see what happens.
Well, indeed. Plus, we'll be hearing and seeing the King of Wrestling, Jerry Lawler, in just a couple of moments. Also, a host of other great matches, but right now, a special word. Move out against Roger Bond. One fall, a 10-minute time limit. Quick takedown by Sawyer, and brother, he wastes no time. He is an all-purpose, all-aggressive wrestler. He uses every part of his body as a lethal weapon against his opponent. And Bond, who I think has a great future in this sport, is suddenly getting a real, real lesson here.
Well, he is. Buzz is all hyped up, ready to go. Anytime you've got somebody like Ellering on your back, you've got to be ready. And I don't think I can, there's nobody I can think of that'd be more ready than Buzz Sawyer.
Sawyer brings him up. Right round. Beautiful belly-to-belly souple. Count of three. Count of three. It is all over, and the Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
You talk about record times, Gordon. Look on your stopwatch. That's got to be a record.
Got to be, or not real close to it. Buzz Sawyer, the victor. Demand on Ronnie Garvin, $35,000 for Jake the Snake to defend his title here on television. And I understand, too, that You're bringing in some other people.
Doesn't Buzz look good, Gordon? You know, the best things in life are free. You're watching me right now, and it doesn't cost you a penny. But that's all that Garvin can say. $35,000, Garvin. That's what you must pay. Put your house up. I don't care what it takes. If you want to wrestle Jake the Snake, it's $35,000. Now, you're talking about bringing in a lot of men. Well, I am. I'm bringing Joe LaDuke, and you just saw what he can do, Buzz Sawyer. And I'm talking about my Road Warriors. I'm talking about Jake the Snake. Nobody beats the Legion of Doom. Nobody. I don't care who you bring. Jerry Lawler, Ronnie Garvin, Buzz Sawyer. Bring them on, one and all, because all of you will fall.
Let's take a look at Jerry Lawler right now. King of Wrestling, Jerry Lawler. And, of course, your Road Warriors no longer have the national title.
Jerry Lawler, the Road Warriors aren't Andy Kaufman. Bring them on. Now, Stan Hansen, you're a thorn in my side, and you're like all the other wrestlers around here. You're like a river. There's more at the mouth than the source. I don't see you doing anything to the Road Warriors. I don't see you doing anything to Jake the Snake. It doesn't matter who you are. Come on, one and all, because you're all going to fall, because Precious Paul is going to rule wrestling like Charlemagne, like Alexander the Great, like Adolf Hitler.
Let's take a look at these Road Warriors that he's talking about right now. National television champion in action, Jake the Snake Roberts. Mr. Ellering, I would assume that you're going to the ring.
I'm going to the ring to watch perfection.
All right, Jake the Snake Roberts getting set to move out against Mike Starbuck. One fall, a 10-minute time limit. A special happy birthday to Denise Clark and to David Allen. Nice to have David Bashford here today from Ocala, Florida. The Mulkey family from Scottsdale, Georgia. Frank Eldridge of Buffalo, New York is here. It's a takedown by Jake the Snake. Front chancery, in effect.
You want to give up now, boy, if you want.
Jake the Snake, who is a dangerous, dangerous competitor. Starbuck coming up very, very slowly. Jake the Snake brings him up. Full body slam. Starbuck in all kinds of trouble here as Jake the Snake completely controlling the entire match. Standing on one ankle and using the flat of the foot into the calf muscles of that leg. Starbuck's going to have a lot of problems with that leg. Jake the Snake now punishing the femoris muscles and the hamstring. Jake the Snake brings him up. Looked like he was going for a vertical souffle. Instead, crashed him down. Face forward. The DDT. The DDT. And nobody gets up from that. Nobody gets up from the DDT. And so the victor in this match, the national television champion, Jake the Snake Roberts. Now here's a special word.
January 15th, 8:30, a sensational card. It'll be Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer taking on one of wrestling's strongest, toughest, meanest men, Big Joe LaDuke, National Heavyweight Championship, Ted DiBiase, champion, against Marietta Georgia's Bob Armstrong, six-man tag, the Road Warriors, and killer Carl Krupp, against Jerry Briscoe, Brett Wayne, and Bugsy McGraw. TV title, Jake the Snake Roberts, champion, takes on the king of wrestling, Jerry Lawler. Ron Garvin clashes with Pistol Pez Watley. Tommy Rogers against Brad Armstrong, winner to meet Les Thornton, for the world's junior heavyweight title. Plus other matches including King Kong Bundy's challenge to Atlanta for $15,000. That's the Omni in Atlanta, January 15th.
Don't forget, of course, great wrestling tonight in Marietta at the Cobb County Civic Center.
Yeah, don't forget about Marietta, DiBiase. Big Joe LaDuke, you get out here, you pull big trains, you're getting in, you're acting real crazy. We'll see what you can do with the Mad Dog. See what you can do with the Mad Dog on the 15th. I got to get back to my own mean self. I'm ready for you, LaDuke. Come grab a hold of this pinball.
Now to talk to the Road Warriors. They are the former national tag team champions. They were defeated, of course, by Buzz Sawyer and Brett Sawyer. And, well, gentlemen, I know a rematch is in the offing.
That's right. All you little weasels out there, they get bigger and better than the Warriors. Well, let me tell you something. There ain't nobody better than the Warriors. Wait, Hawk.
You're all open-hand material if you don't know what open-hand material is. We don't have to close that.
Now, here's a special word. One fall, 10-minute time limit is Chick Donovan moving out against Wahoo McDaniel. Donovan moves out very swiftly, collar and elbow. And it's Donovan watching his Chief Wahoo McDaniel, of course, has been an athlete all of his life. Right from the very, very beginning of his grade school career on into high school, of course, Oklahoma. In fact, he still holds a record in Oklahoma. My knowledge is yet to be broken. Went on then, of course, into pro football and pro wrestling. Loves the one-on-one contact. Top of that, he's an avid fisherman, hunter, diver. He does it all and does it well. Chick Donovan, young, very aggressive, a third-generation athlete. His grandfather was one of the greats in the lightweight ranks in boxing. Whoa! Chop into the chest and one into the head that puts Donovan down. Snapmare by Donovan. Donovan. Tied up, and it is Wahoo McDaniel is keeping his man immobile. Donovan knows what he's facing here in Wahoo McDaniels. He knows the experience, the savvy that this man has. Donovan coming up rather slowly. Full body slam by Wahoo. Snap Camp Mayor. Double rear chin lock, although he's not really across the chin, he's across just under the cheekbones. Donovan having his problems here, a test of strength as Donovan tries to extricate himself. Uses that elbow effectively, then the forearm, another forearm. As Wahoo McDaniel staggered backwards momentarily, and Donovan now explodes on Chief Wahoo McDaniel. Another snapmare, and as Donovan tried to go for the leg, it was Wahoo McDaniel. A couple of chops that puts Donovan back to the canvas again. Wahoo McDaniel catches him once again. They count a three. It is all over for Chick Donovan. And so Chief Wahoo McDaniel is the victor.
January 15th, 8:30, a sensational card. It'll be Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer taking on one of wrestling's strongest, toughest, meanest men, Big Joe LaDuke. National Heavyweight Championship, Ted DiBiase, champion against Marietta, Georgia's Bob Armstrong. Six-man tag, the Road Warriors and killer Carl Krupp against Jerry Briscoe, Brett Wayne, and Bugsy McGraw. TV title, Jake the Snake Roberts, champion, takes on the King of Wrestling, Jerry Lawler. Ron Garvin clashes with Pistol Pez Watley. Tommy Rogers against Brad Armstrong, winner to meet Les Thornton for the World Junior Heavyweight title. Plus other matches including King Kong Bundy's challenge to Atlanta for 15,000. That's the Omni in Atlanta, January 15th.
National Tag Team Champions.
You're with the Road Warriors. We have whipped the Funks. We have whipped the Briscoes. We have whipped the Armstrongs. We have whipped the Sawyers. And basically all they amount to is open hand material. For you people out there who don't know what it is, this is open hands. They're punks. We don't need to close a fist. They're open hands.
Well, I think you've made your point abundantly clear. Let me take a moment to talk to Mr. Ellering, because I'm surprised that you haven't demanded a rematch with the Sawyers.
Gordon Solly, it's all in the making. You, of course, understand the ramifications of contracts as well as I do. And it's all in the making, and you can rest assured of that. Now, there's a lot of wrestlers that walk around here. They're like a mighty Mississippi, flowing. Well, there's a lot more at the mouth of the river than there is at the source. And by that, I mean everybody wants us, but nobody can beat the Legion of Doom. Right, Jake?
Paul is so right. You know, I've had this for a while, and I'm going to keep it a lot longer. As far as you, Ronnie Garvin, sell your house, brother, because you're going to need it, because I need the money. And if you want the shot at this, you're going to have to put the money up, because I haven't got time to be wasting on people like you, ex-champions. I mean, let's get Flair in there. Who do we want, Paul? Who do we want? Anybody that can beat me, step on up, because I'm ready.
King Kong Bundy is $15,000, continues to draw interest.
That's right, Gordon. I'm drawing plenty of interest, and that's good because I like money. But I want people to know everywhere I go, I'm going to have my $15,000 ready for anybody who wants to take the $15,000 challenge. All you big, bad construction workers, all you weightlifters, come on out to the arena, baby. $15,000.
Okay, fair enough. There have been some comers, but nobody's been able to take
Gordon
it yet.
Solly, I heard Johnny Rich out here today talking about, I better look out that Tommy Rich is going to get me. I heard Ole Anderson, you were talking about, I better look out for Tommy Rich. I beat Tommy Rich. He's out of professional wrestling. What's he going to do, buy a ticket, come to the matches? He's entitled to do that. But if he does, if he's dumb enough, he better stay in his seat, because if he's dumb enough to get in that ring, not only will I beat you up, Tommy Rich, I'll make it very, very sure that you won't ever get in a ring anywhere again. And you saw what I did to his cousin today. I paddled his backside a little bit. Boy, it just started.
Well, that's an interesting observation from one Ted DiBiase.
Out of wrestling. Supposed to be gone. If he comes back, sticks his nose in my business, I'm going to put him out of the ring.
Thanks for watching the best of championship wrestling. The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated.